the weight of history is more on the side of this than not. You know, I started to just sort of see that, like, this is not even a, like, he had made such a strong case that I just intellectually actually felt like it's not even smart to reject this. You know, it just doesn't seem like a good intellectual decision. Mm-hmm. So I think I sort of nominally thought, yeah, you know, I'm like that, but I'm not one of those crazies, you know. Right. And then I really, I mean, it was just sort of like God sort of invading my life. It was very unwelcome and I didn't like it. And, you know, all of a sudden I started having a lot of different experiences where I just felt, you know, God doing a lot of things in my life. It's kind of hard to describe, but I did just have this moment of the scales falling off of my eyes and just saying, it's just totally true. Like, I don't even have any doubt.
Mm-hmm. I think all of us that are Christian understand exactly what you're saying because we go through similar experiences.
Rather than what I would have thought it would be like, which is, you know, the clouds part and the angels sing and it's all so wonderful, it was horrible because all of a sudden I thought, well, what am I supposed to do now? You know, I don't know. I mean, I don't want to be one of these people and I'm not a Republican and I don't want to, you know, I just had nothing in common with them and I didn't know any Christians. And so I was really quite freaked out and really resisted it, frankly, for a while. And I thought maybe I'm having an episode or some sort of bad, you know, I really thought this is like a phase and it's going to pass. And
it sounds like the kind of courage that enabled you to really come to Christ and embrace that which you said you would never ever do really was similar to what you needed to have when you went after this story.
See, I don't really feel like I have any courage. It's interesting when you say that. And even when describing, like, when I became a Christian, I just gave in. You know, I wasn't even, it wasn't courageous. I didn't have any choice. I kept trying to not believe and I kept just couldn't avoid it. It was, if I could have avoided it, I would have. There's nothing convenient about it in my life, in the world that I live in. It's not like living in the South or living somewhere where everybody's a Christian. I live in a world where nobody's a believer.